Well, shit just hit the fan there. Oh, she's unconscious. I mean, you would have thought that when we went and defeated Garland. Now, Garland was a sort of perpetrator, the one that was causing this whole world takey over kind of garbage. And Kuja was his puppet. I guess he would have to have really killed both of them in order to end the threat. But things seem like they're different now. Big hurry, huh? The threat, you could say, is probably finished. I don't think Terra is really in a position to go in, although the plan might still play out. The architect behind the whole thing is dead. But we may still have a problem, or we definitely do have a problem. Kuja found out that he's immortal, and it seems like we've got a situation of, well, if I'm going to die, and he's probably going to die pretty soon, he wants to take everything down with me. And that's its own threat there. And he may very well be powerful enough to actually do it now. I mean, he's absorbed all the souls that the Invincible has. Various cities that have been destroyed in his presence. And he's absorbed their power, and now he is a true force to be reckoned with. Maybe he could do it. Certainly seemed like he was quite powerful. Thank you. Well, there we go. We've reached the end of Disc 3, and we've seen what Kuja has planned. We had stopped the mist back in Disc 2. But it wasn't over. Part of his plan to destroy Gaia now, as well as Terra, is to cover the entire world with mist. Now there's no way to escape it. And we're going to have to see what happens in the next episode. Thanks for watching.